over the control to drive friendly advanced communicator for communicator leader to lead the speech evaluation success.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Evening, Emily. This session is the moment of PE. Guys, by the way, PE is not a prize winning. The moment of positive experience. Positive experience of communication for the speakers. Positive experience of leadership for the role players. So now, I would like to go to the first section, is the speech evaluations. Tonight, we have three experienced evaluators to evaluate our speakers. So let's welcome the first evaluators to evaluate the first speaker right now. So let's put our hand to welcome advanced communicators and competence leader Alan Tam.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Toastmaster Ryan Tang, in your quest to talk about small gestures of kindness, your assignment asked for you to be able to enhance the different stance, movement, gestures, facial expressions, and eye contact. They needed to enhance your speech. And it's a tall challenge because you do too little, we don't quite follow you. Right? If you do too much, we feel that's going to be a put on. So the center of gravity here is anything and everything that you did must have enhanced your speech. I like the fact that you were very intentional in starting out way at the corner. It's like, hey, what's he doing there? So there's an element of surprise. And there's attention grabbing. That was good. And there was a small sketch that was involved there. I saw animation, I saw gestures, I saw moving, I saw expressions. So it helped me to feel the emotions of regret, which quickly shifted to being anxious, to hopelessness, as you were trying to give us an imagery of the lift. That was clear. As you move on to talk about plastic rubbish and how that is affecting us on a worldwide level, I hear you, for me to feel that, I think that you were trying to get us to adopt the position. I think that's the chief aim whenever we come up here, is either to get us to adopt a position or a call for action. And for me, in both of all this, you need us to be on your side. What I mean by that is, to many of us, haven't we seen rubbish around? We have. How many of us actually would really, really bother picking up the rubbish? I'm not going to ask for a show of hands. But the thing here is, you were so keen on getting us to have this taste of disgust with rubbish, it would have done well to really paint that imagery of gooey stuff which is lingering all around and the kind of stench, you know, that you needed to bring that home point for me to even consider, yeah, I'm going to do my part to make sure that I don't wallow, or my future generation don't wallow in that pile of rubbish. So, I think certain gestures come very natural to you. I can't help but imagine that you and rapping come so natural because you do things like you do this very naturally. So, it is you. But I think if we use back the stance, when you want to enhance your message, you gotta learn and it's gonna take some practice. So, do come more often to practice how to make sure that it's not too little and it's not too good on. And ultimately, you must push yourself so that your speech will be enhanced through very careful orchestration of your gestures. You need to be in a control position. I know it's a bit of a challenge. On one side, we say be natural, then be control. But do this so that you will be able to enhance your speeches with your eyes. I submit this time back to the general director.
Evaluate speakers, EJ. Yeah. So let's put our hand to welcome distinguished Toastmaster Gan Tian Hock.
Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Toastmasters and guests, it's my pleasure to evaluate EJ. Toastmaster EJ, your objective for this speech is to persuade us to follow your whatever appeal that you want to message to us. And in this particular case, I think your specific purpose is to deliver the message to ask everyone on the floor to treasure the family bond, right? To enhance that, to embrace the family and to say something nice, do something nice for your parents. So, how have you achieved that? Now, you started off with a very interesting question, nothing to do with your subject matter, I thought. And your question, your title is also very mysterious, because I think none of us know what you're going to talk about when you have such a title, Branches and Bonds. And you started off by talking about Chinese New Year, Ang Pao and all that. So we were all eagerly waiting to see what you are going to deliver. I thought that is very good attention grabber. On the other hand, in my opinion, it seems to be a little bit, the transition seems to be a little bit loose, because I couldn't really follow your opening to your body of the speech. In fact, throughout your speech, you were like jumping from one point to another. But what I particularly like about your speech is when you talk about your mother's cancer and the way she held your hand and talked to you. I thought that is a very strong emotional appeal there. It could be even further enhanced if you were to dramatize it a bit and perhaps speak with, characterize your mother's character by probably using a different voice, you know, to differentiate how your mother would have spoken to you. I thought that part you could have added some vocal variety to enhance that emotional appeal, and that would have been a very good emotional appeal to us to bring it to your final message. So your final message, I thought your conclusion is a little bit rushed. You basically just say Chinese New Year is around the corner, and how many of us have, you know, said something nice to our parents and so on. I thought if you would have called for action, perhaps you ask us to go home tonight, hug your parents and say I love you or something like that, I think that would have been a very strong appeal to us and a very good closing. All in all, I like your speech, and I think you have achieved your objective of persuading us, at least for me. So I look forward to your final speech in this manner. Back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Gan. Yeah, Gan has a way of evaluation is more critical, because he point out the specific objective of the speech and then let the speakers know what are the specific areas of the program, because this is a sign of the line. So one more stage then you will go to. So next we will invite the last speaker to evaluate the final speakers, Josh, to the assignment number 9 as well. So let's put our hand to welcome Kelvin, Advanced Communicator Civil, Advanced Leadership Boss.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight, we had the privilege to listen to our speaker, Josh O'Neill, to take the next step to greater heights. I, for one, enjoy your speech, Josh. To listen to you, or where I sat, I could almost feel what you have gone through. The burning passion flows in your blood, which I believe is still flowing. The adrenaline punch to call us, to invite us to join this movement for greater glory, for greater movement. I felt Josh, as you stood here, you told us your experience, your life, and perhaps your future, what you want to achieve, and hopefully each and every one of us, particularly the guests, will perhaps join you. However, because this assignment requires you to persuade us with conviction. Therefore, the end message to your last closing your speech. What is it that you want to tell us? The whole story, I was trying to juggle. We try to inspire us that what you have achieved throughout your 50 years of life, in your profession or social, or we try to convince the sitting fans, our guests right here, should we join or shouldn't we join or should we join later? If we decide to join, will we call for action? We say, tonight I will join you no matter where you are. So, you had the gist. It's just that this spark of ingredients, it doesn't really then spice up the dish. Nonetheless, the whole package is very well done. The speech is perfectly organized. We will follow you well. Simple language is just enough for us to feel what you're going through. Nonetheless, taking the first step is indeed get done. I believe those of us friends who are not yet joined as Toastmaster member will one day join the army of his force. Therefore, may the force be with us. Okay.
Well done. Okay, next we would like to work for the best developer, so can you kindly